Hello, this is Hound4004, and welcome to Minecraft News. I will go over leaks and reveals from the devs of Minecraft. Everything that I will go over in today's video will be linked in order in the description below if you want to check them out for yourselves. But for now, let's get started. So starting off here, we have an image from Henrik of a stalactite. So it's kind of funny to see one that is this big. It has a geode spawn inside it, so if we are able to get ones that generate this big, that would be pretty cool. As with everything fun though, it probably won't be able to actually happen, because never mind the weird cave shape, it is a temporary parking garage style cave that is able to like have you be able to test some of the new dripstones. And then he later on says that, like, maybe because of how big it is, that it would be super rare to ever get one that big from the floor to ceiling. So, unfortunately, although it is cool, it'll probably never be a thing, but it'll be something to keep your eyes open to. So here's another thing from Henrik, going with cave generation. So we got some things to sort out before we can snapshot the new cave generation. And now we're going on Xmas break, so don't hold your breath. So when the snapshots resume on January, we should not expect, maybe for a while yet, for the whole new cave generation system to be implemented. So we'll hopefully see this soon, but probably not right away. So it is still something to look forward to yet in quite a bit future. And here's another thing from Henrik, saying we added a minimum velocity for the trident, breaking stalactites, in order to avoid problems like this, the trident pogo stick. So unfortunately this is a bug, but I'll show you this video here. So then he says, I agree, it is funny and quirky, but from an actual playtesting, it turned out to be mostly a pain, because when you've thrown your trident, you want it back as quickly as possible, so you can throw it again. Of course, this stops you from getting it back, until, of course, all the stalagmites are broken. Yet again, here is another thing from Henrik, and he has a little gif. So this is teaching mobs to not walk on stalagmites. They seem to be getting it now, so you can kind of see how he's like trying to make it so the mobs won't walk on the stalagmites when pathfinding. So someone asked Henrik, say, have you worked on that light source to enlighten big caves? And Henrik replied, yes. So the new block or whatever it will be for the cave lighting has been worked on, so hopefully we'll get that sometime pretty soon in snapshots. So here's a quick one for the technical community. Someone asked Felix, why is Minecraft single-threaded instead of multi-threaded? And Felix said, it does not use some threads. It's not entirely single-threaded. The core gameplay was built entirely around one thread since day one. Changing that will break big features like redstone. The technical community understands this best. We have to be careful as we build towards multi-threading. So whatever that means, it is probably some bit of news, so anyways. So Olraf finally noticed something that, for the first time, he noticed the end cities were not centered. So I don't know if this really means anything, but now that a dev actually knows about it, it may get it closer to finally getting fixed. So here's kind of maybe something sad for the building community. So someone put out there, it feels really natural to have grass slash dirt slabs. I do not know why they won't add them into the game. Now KingBDogs went ahead and say, I may be in the minority, but that doesn't feel very natural to Minecraft for me. This game is defined by staying on a block grind for natural generation. Very few things break this rule. Now honestly to me, it does not look too great in this natural generation, but I think we still should be able to craft dirt slabs or something. But even being able to do that, this may put a little pull on it, so who knows if we'll ever get dirt slabs. The marketplace gifts still go on here for a bit in the marketplace yet, so definitely go check it out. The latest one was a map again and another skin. So go to the marketplace, check that out while they are free and around. So, of course, there's been a new Minecraft beta for Bedrock this week, 1.16.210.53. So this beta was basically more adding some more features about the powdered snow. They finally have the powdered snow bucket. It wasn't that big of a snapshot for Caves and Cliffs features, but hopefully for the Bedrock Edition, more Caves and Cliffs features will be on their way towards the beginning of next year, January. So, of course, earlier in this week, Minecraft Snapshot 20W51A released with axolotls. So, I made a video of that earlier in the week, so check that out if you want to, the link is in the description. So Megaspud put out there's a lot more Caves and Cliffs stuff in the works. We'll have more to share in the new year. The teams are working very hard, so thanks for your patience. So it's good to know that they are working on it, and that more snapshots and betas will be coming. As you may or may not know though, the Minecraft devs are on Christmas break, so there will be no more snapshots, betas, releases, or anything like that this year anymore. So, unfortunately, that is probably it for Minecraft news this year, unless some magic happens. So here's kind of something weird here. So KingBDogs has been posting a lot of things with Carp, and so if anyone asks him if Carp is coming to Minecraft, he will respond with the word Carp. So that probably means nothing, but all I have to say about that is Carp. So this here is the ending, and this kind of goes to the ending of one of my Minecraft news in the past, when I showed an image of a mac and cheese warden with a mac and cheese skulk sensor. Someone went ahead and built the mac and cheese warden in the game, so that is actually pretty cool. And I cannot wait to have texture packs come out with mac and cheese wardens when Caves and Cliffs and the warden comes out. But that is pretty much all now. Hope this was helpful, hope you enjoyed, hope you have happy holidays, and for now, this is Helm4004 saying goodbye.